Hello friends, welcome to Study IQ. Today we are going to talk about the latest news where Kamala Harris has been nominated as the running mate to Joe Biden, who is presidential candidate from the Democratic Party. You must have heard of the news a couple of days back. Kamala Harris, a senator from California, she has been chosen as a vice presidential candidate, that is the running mate of the current presidential ticket holder from Democratic Party, Joe Biden. This is Kamala Harris. So in this video, we are going to first talk about Kamala Harris in short. I'm going to give you some details about Kamala Harris, her background. Then if she becomes vice president, what are the powers that she is going to hold? And eventually, we'll end up the discussion with whether there would be a good impact or a bad impact on India with respect to Indo-US relations if Kamala Harris becomes the vice president. So let's begin our discussion. Let's first know about Kamala Harris. Kamala Harris, she was born in Oakland in California in 1964. Her mother, Shyamala Gopalan, is a very renowned cancer researcher. She is Indian by origin. Shyamala Gopalan's family even now resides in Chennai. There are many relatives who, as of today, also stay in Chennai, and they have been very happy with this particular announcement that Kamala Harris has become vice presidential candidate. Apart from that, her father, Donald Harris, was an economist from Jamaica. Both of them emigrated basically from their respective countries into US in 1970s. Apart from that, a very interesting information about Kamala is that her mother, Shyamala, chose her name as Kamala because of her Indian roots. In India, we already know that Kamala means lotus. It is also another name for Hindu goddess Lakshmi, which symbolizes the empowerment of women. In fact, Kamala Harris's mother, Shyamala, she believed that any society which worships goddesses would focus on woman empowerment also. In fact, it is said that Kamala Harris, she visited India when she was a child, and she was heavily influenced by her grandfather, that is maternal grandfather, P.V. Gopalan, who was a high-ranking government official in India. And it is also said that P.V. Gopalan was also involved in freedom struggle of India. As a child, it is said that Kamala Harris, she went to Black Baptist Church and Hindu temple. So it is a very interesting news that Kamala Harris has become the first woman of color to be nominated to such a high post. Last time around in 2016, we know that Hillary Clinton was the presidential candidate from Democratic Party, but this time from Democratic Party, vice presidential candidate is Kamala Harris, first woman of color. Apart from that, let's look at Kamala Harris's educational background. Kamala Harris has studied in Harvard University. Remember, it is not Harvard, it is H-O-W-A-R-D, Harvard University. This university is a renowned black college present in Washington, D.C. Her subjects in her graduation were political science and economics. After completion of her graduation, she was interested in law and she took up law in San Francisco. After becoming an attorney in 2003, she ran for election of district attorney in San Francisco. She won the election. In fact, she became the first black woman in California to be elected as district attorney. And later on, she also became first black woman to be elected attorney general of California. In fact, when she was attorney general of California, one of the greatest accomplishments that she has achieved is with respect to a project known as Open Justice. And I would advise the students to go and watch this or read about Open Justice. It is a very great development where an online platform has been developed to make the entire criminal justice system as transparent as possible in California, and this can be owed to Kamala Harris. Apart from that, let's look at her political journey. Before that, in 2014, she married Doug Emhoff, a renowned corporate lawyer. Doug Emhoff already has two children from his previous marriage. And a very interesting snippet about Kamala Harris: after she was nominated to be running mate of Joe Biden, she was asked a question, would she be happy if people started to call her VP, that is vice president? And she very interestingly said that she would like to hear Momala rather than VP. Momala is a name which children of Doug Emhoff call Kamala. It's a mixture of mom plus Kamala Momala. Very interesting story. Apart from that, her political journey began in 2016 when she won the US Senate race from California. After she became a senator, she has been a huge critic of the entire Trump administration. She has been heavily critical of Trump's policies, especially with respect to immigration, with respect to visa. She has been continuously questioning the Russian intervention in US election. In fact, she also questioned Trump administration's nomination of Brett Kavanaugh as a judge to Supreme Court. She continuously grilled Brett Kavanaugh in one of the interviews. A very interesting information about Kamala Harris is that she was also offered to become a judge of Supreme Court during the Barack Obama administration, but she declined the offer. Apart from that, in 2009, she started her bid for US presidential ticket from the Democratic Party, but eventually she had to end her campaign in December 2019, and in March 2020, she finally endorsed Joe Biden. It is believed that one of the reasons for the failure of her campaign was her failure to completely be very clear about her policies when it comes to criminal justice system. Apart from that, her ideas on healthcare were not very clear. She could not connect with the masses. That is why she had to end her presidential campaign. And finally, in August 2020, recently we see that she has become running mate to Joe Biden. Let's look at what are the powers of vice president if at all she becomes vice president in future. Before that, Study IQ has brought a very interesting news for you. On all our courses, we are giving 5% discount. For more information, download the Study IQ app from Play Store. In United States, the powers of vice presidents are quite limited. Although vice president is the second highest officer in the executive branch, just below the president, but the vice president is very similar to vice president of India in terms of power, except for one particular provision which we'll look at. The vice president of US also presides over the upper house, that is the Senate. So if at all she becomes vice president, she's going to look after all the deliberation of the Senate. She will also preside over the joint session of Congress. In India, it is the Lok Sabha speaker, but in US, it is the vice president who presides over the joint sessions. Apart from that, the vice president also has the powers to preside over the impeachment trials, whatever takes place. If there is an impeachment of president also, then the vice president will preside over that session. But a very stark difference between Indian vice president and the US vice president is this particular point, where the US vice president will overtake all the powers and duties of the president if at all president is removed, if the president dies, if the president resigns, and if the president is unable to perform their duties. Here, a very interesting news comes. Can Kamala Harris become president at all in the 4-year term if she gets elected from 2020 to 2024? There have been news reports that say that Joe Biden, who is 77 years old, In fact, he's going to become one of the oldest US presidents if at all he is elected in 2021. But the question arises over his ability to perform the job of a president. Already reports are coming about his cognitive abilities. We have seen many videos where Joe Biden is speaking something and suddenly stops and loses the track of the discussion. So there is a conjecture that in future, probably in couple of years, there is a possibility that vice president may take over president's job if at all the president becomes unable or if he is removed or resigns for any particular reason. So there is a very important case here that Vice President Kamala Harris, if at all she becomes, she is going to have huge impact over the entire US administration, and we need to be particular about the Indo-US relations. So let's look at how Kamala Harris might impact the Indo-US relations. So we are going to look at what's in store for us. In general, there are majority of skeptics, that means those who do not believe that India is going to benefit from Kamala Harris's election as vice president. Mainly because Kamala Harris has always taken tough positions on law and order and on human rights. And she has been very, very critical about India's step of abrogation of Article 370. Particularly over the issue of civil liberties in Jammu and Kashmir and non-connectivity of internet in Jammu and Kashmir. So many people do suggest that Indians must not be overexcited with Kamala Harris's nomination because she might not be as beneficial to India. We also know that Kamala Harris has been very critical of Indian administration, particularly Trump administration. In December 2019, Kamala Harris sent out a tweet very strongly criticizing the Indian Ministry of External Affairs. She said that one of her compatriots, representative Pramila Jaipal, she was declined. Basically, her offer was declined by the Ministry of External Affairs, and Kamala Harris criticized S. Jaishankar, the Indian foreign minister. So the future may look a little bleak, because even if Kamala Harris comes or becomes a vice president, it might not lead to better relations between India and USA. But there is also a silver lining. There are many optimists who think that when Kamala Harris would become vice president, there would be much better policy in terms of immigration and visa rules. Everybody knows that Kamala Harris has been pro-immigration and pro-green cards. In fact, after her announcement as vice presidential candidate, Kamala Harris herself said that she is going to lift cap on the employment-based green cards. Most of the beneficiaries are from India and China. Apart from that, Kamala Harris herself has a huge support base of Indian American community. This will lead eventually to better benefits for Indian diaspora in USA. Nonetheless, these are all conjectures. Only time will tell whether Joe Biden becomes president, whether Kamala Harris becomes vice president. These are all just the predictions for future and are very, very important from Indian foreign policy makers, because we need to be ready for any kind of future. If at all there are any updates on this particular issue, we will continuously keep on bringing to you. If you like this video, you can follow me on Instagram, RahulSai222, or you can also subscribe to my channel with the same name. Thank you very much. Have a great day.